Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Emnix Plays Grim Dawn. Last time around, we managed to kill the warden. I'm excited, man. I'm excited to do all this new shit. So I guess we have some new quests, and we have to repair the bridge leading northwest out of Devil's Crossing.
Got any more scrap metal?
We actually managed to pick up a brain matter from last time around, and that gives us an empowered relic. Not too sure what it does, but you know, we can give it a try. Now, which one would I want? Calamity? It gives us physical damage, fire damage, and 5% chance on attack to do some kind of calamity. Tranquility, it gives us elemental damage and spirit. Or ruination, which gives us pierce damage. And I don't know, what does that look like? Rapid strike. This seems pretty cool. Let's try ruination. I'm assuming you put it in this slot right here. So this is another piece of equipment. So cunning and attack speed. What's arcane forging? Okay, let's combine. Okay, so we even got an achievement. So we got completion bonus plus 13% cold damage. That seems pretty good. So we actually got a new skill then, right? What's this new skill? Rapid strike. I can't put in my left click though. 80 energy cost, 20 second skill recharge. Wow, that's a very long time. And then we want to put slam and we want this devotion onto slam. Okay. All right. Let's give this a try. So this is basically our big upgrade, I guess. This ruination relic right here, as well as the one-handed axe. And I'm hoping that these are enough stats to kind of carry us for the next couple levels. I need to repair this bridge. 6 scrap and 3,000 iron bits. Repair. Kill Edmund Shanks Doyle. Yo, Luffy would not be happy about this. Let's turn on our buffs. These guys are level 22, so they're pretty strong actually.
I can't do that yet.
Oh, that's not the skill I wanted to use. Okay. I mean, it seems pretty easy so far. These guys are pretty weak. But you never know, right? So it looks like Rapid Strike is more of a skill that I would use sort of over time or on a big boss. Because it has a pretty long cooldown. Now, I could continue to explore this area. And I think I will, but if I find that, you know, maybe I'm underleveled or maybe they're too strong for me, I might step back for a bit and you know, go back to the area we were at before and try to just get a couple levels there first. You know, that's also an option. Oh my god. So is this Shanks? Shanks! Why is your hair not red? Okay, let's get these range guys first. Keep shooting at me. Oh my. Oh, we need to heal. Okay, yeah. I don't think we want to be here. This is not a good idea. This was not a good idea. I regret it already. Okay, we'll try and do this quest and we'll kind of kite them, but we probably don't want to fight this just yet. Oh, my Lanta. Oh, this is scary. We are not tanky at all. Okay, heal up, heal up. We can do it. Oh my god. Who's shooting at me? This guy. I missed? Alright. Now I can kind of give this rapid strike an actual, you know, a good old college try.
That skill's not ready.
It didn't work. Okay, well, we killed this guy, but, yeah, I don't think I want to be here. Not just yet. My character is not adequately leveled. You'll pay for this. Rest in peace, scum. Who is shooting at me, dog? Where is he? Oh, here he is. Alright, report back to Morning Devil's Crossing. Darius wants this prison, and when he finds out what you've done, you'll wish I shanked you dead. Well, rip. Okay, let's turn this quest in.
Well,
Mornay.
Did they like our housewarming gift?
I killed the man in charge by the name Shanks.
You work fast. I like that. We'll need more of that, Darius.
What's our next target?
Last I've seen his face, they almost hung him for a double homicide. The warden intervened at the last minute in favor of a life sentence in Devil's Crossing. Seems there were ulterior motives after all. Darius Cronley is the devil made manifest, devious and manipulative with a penchant for sin of every kind. He's the one running this gang, and he's the one we need to go after next.
All right, fair enough. Do you have
a
plan?
We have to hit them hard and fast. Leave no room for a counterstrike. I've only seen a portion of their operations in the region, but they are really
what about a global offensive?
Four hills in old Arcovia. Shank surely wasn't Darius's only lieutenant, so I suggest you find the rest and kill them. We don't want one of them taking over after Darius is dealt with. I don't have any names for you, but they will probably have equally clever prison names as our dead friend Shanks. But to really end this, you need to cut off the head of this operation, Darius Cronley. If what I hear is true, you will find him hiding out in the mines underneath the four hills. Lastly, my scouting partner Elsa must still be out there with them. If I venture to guess, Cronley has her in his clutches. Save her from that brute. I hear you are quite capable, so don't let me down. When you find yourself out there, I recommend you seek out a man by the name Quaid. He and his group forsook the peaceful ways of the Rovers in favor of fighting back against the outlaws. And I'm glad they did. It was Quaid's people that pulled me from the jaws of death.
That's a lot of stuff. A lot of information. So, basically, I guess the next few quests are related to Cronley's gang. And it makes sense, right? So, we moved on from the zombies on to the humans. It's a different faction altogether, right? There's Cronley's gang. There's the Rovers. Devil's Crossing. Yeah. But for now, I actually think I want to go back to Burridge and do a little bit of exploring. Because we haven't fully explored this area, and at this point, you know, we've gotten a few more levels. It might be a good idea to check the areas out again. I mean, I think there are a lot of secret areas which I just kind of skipped because we weren't strong enough. But now we can kind of come back and see if we can find anything good. And either way, you know, I kind of need this time to level up. Because we clearly were lacking in the defensive department. I'm not too sure what I'm supposed to do there. But, yeah, I don't know. But hopefully a few levels will help. A lot of it is kind of associated with the fact that we haven't been allocating our skills very efficiently. And the other half, I guess, comes down to gear as well. Mostly skills, I think. Mostly skills. And a little bit, you know, low levels, low skill points, and bad items. So we kind of need a little bit of everything at this point. I don't know, leveling here, just picking up a few levels, maybe to level 25, level 26, and then doing the Cronley stuff, That might be a good idea, which is basically what I'm going to try to do now. I mean, even in these areas, right, these fights, they're a bit of a challenge. Not exactly a breeze in the park, far from it, actually. And if we start hitting a wall, you know, this is still, I would consider, like, obviously I don't know much about the game, but I would consider this area still, like, you know, beginner tutorial kind of zones, or like Act 1, I guess. And the fact that we're struggling here, I don't know. I feel like we should probably farm a bit. Just my opinion. Okay, what does Rapid Strike do? More attack speed. Less offensive ability, but we attack faster. 5 second duration. Oh, I see. It's kind of like Berserk mode. Well, that's not as cool as I thought it would be, but it's okay, I guess. Now, one thing that I forgot to mention from last episode, or maybe a couple episodes ago, is that when we picked up this devotion skill, Tsunami, it actually gains experience. So as we sort of get more experience, this similar to Path of Exile, the skill actually levels up, which makes it stronger over time, all that stuff. So that's kind of interesting. Like that's something that we're a little bit more familiar with, and I guess that's the only area where skills were actually level up. So there's a little bit of variety everywhere, you know. Certain on your skill tree itself, you're just leveling it using skill points, but the devotion tree, those skills are leveled through EXP. Okay, this was that cave that we were unable to do earlier. Let's see if we have some better luck this time around. Oh man, even now it's tough. These things are so strong. Alright, let's heal up a bit. Level 24, that's good. Although we're still not getting any skill points that we are particularly interested in. But I mean, getting a kill is nice. Ancient Heart. Alright, let's heal up some more. Okay. I think we just killed a boss of some sort. I think. I'm not too sure, to be honest. But he dropped a lot of loot. So I'm guessing if you drop a lot of loot, you're probably a boss. And it just, you know, didn't notice. Alright. Like, we're okay killing them one at a time. It's when they surround us that, you know, we run into some problems. It seems our AoE is not all that good. Alright. I mean, we just need a lot of stuff. We need better items. We need better skills. I spent so many points into masteries that all my skills are pretty gimped at this point. And I feel like I've already, you know, come this far into the masteries. I don't want to stop. We're so close, you know? Like, look, we're at 41, 42 in mastery skills. I would really like to hit that number 50. But, that's probably going to take another, what, 3 levels? So level 27. Oh, man. I think we're at 41 right now. What did we just pick up? Stormcaller Spellblade. Holy crap. That's a cool dagger. Lightning dagger, obviously. So not very useful for us, but, you know, it's good to know. Any new equipment that I might want to equip? And I want to use? No? Alright. I mean, I should put in some components into my armor. It probably makes a pretty big difference. Like, spending the currency early on, especially in veteran mode, where it's like a lot more difficult. It's probably... I'm assuming it's pretty important. Alright, we managed to clear this area. Thank God. So, you know what? Let's head back to town. And let's buff up our equipment a little bit. It's probably worth doing. Ancient heart. What the hell is that? I'm assuming it's a crafting material.
See you around.
Now, what's our reputation like? Friendly. Friendly, you can only give me potions. It's when I am respected that I can actually buy items from this guy. Is there anything to craft, maybe? Not really. Okay, let's stash this away. And let's stash all this as well. Fabric. Complete components. Alright. Are there any components that I can use? Shields, that's pretty useless. Bristly fur. Used in all armor. Okay, so this is an option. Chilled steel, that's still a component. Chipped claw. Used in weapons. Corpse dust. Shield, rings, amulets, and medals. That's an option too. Weapons, no. Head armor, amulets, and medals, but it's energy. I'm not too interested in that. Armor, just armor. I don't want that. Rings, amulets, and medals. I want defensive. Resistances and stuff. Mutated scales is... no. Frozen heart. They both have a frozen heart already. Searing ember is for weapons. That's a ring. Do I want this ring? No. Bleeding damage. No resistances. Skull. Why do I still have this? I need to sell that. Okay. So I guess I'll just use bristly fur and everything. And then a corpse dust on the metal. Okay, so that gave us quite a bit of HP, I guess. Better than nothing. You know, might as well spend our currency early on so we can survive. And then, alright, let's get back into it. Like, I honestly don't think my damage is too bad. It's when I take all these hits that I just run into problems. Alright. I mean, we're getting decent EXP right now. So there's that. Slow progression is better than no progression. So, I'm okay with this. Why do I feel so slow? One sec, sorry. All right, we are back. Are there any unexplored areas? That's what I'm wondering. Because we've been through, like, I'm trying to find the secret spots. Scavengers. Bro, there's like nothing to scavenge. Everything's dead already. I don't see the point. You know? Now, are the beasts technically part of their own faction? Because, I mean, these aren't real... You know, like real creatures. Like scavengers, like what is that? There's a restored shrine. I'm quite sure I've been to all of these areas. I haven't been down there though. Towards the south. Alright. Kappa. Hello. Alright, I think this is... Well, these are unexplored regions, or it looks like it, at least. Oh, what is this? Origin of the Slith. I somehow teleported through the walls into the dank cellar. It looks like there's a secret room there. Have I been there before? You know, one day we'll receive the honor of the golden kappa in our stream. It might not happen for years, but a man can dream. I think I was once in a Northern Line stream, and there was a golden kappa, or someone brought the golden kappa into the stream, and everybody was like going nuts. The chat was going crazy. I think you just get one a day or something like that. Pretty damn rare. That's the dream, man. This is the dream. Get a golden kappa. I wonder what the requirements are. Like, do you have to be a subscriber to some channel, or do you need to be like a special Twitch member? Oh, crumbling wall. Here it is. Okay, so what's... This is a secret area. It's not very secret. And the loot isn't all that good either. What else is there? Weather chest. We get anything good? No. Oh yeah, Origin of the Slith. Is the upgrade path in this similar to Diablo or to PoE? It's a mix of both, actually. Over here is the skill tree. And you can actually take two skill trees. So you kind of combine the two classes. And that is very similar to Diablo in the sense that you allocate passives or you allocate skill points, and that gives you skills. And certain items can give you bonuses towards your skills. So in the case of Diablo or in this game, you know, your Veil of Shadow could be 13 out of 10 or something like that, in which case you can overlevel a certain skill. So you have a limited number of skill points as well as a limited number of devotion points, and devotion points are over here. So this is a little bit more like Path of Exile, where you allocate points towards these constellations. Once you complete a constellation, you get like a big keynote or a special skill. Also, the agreed upon belief for Kappa is that one account per day is granted the Golden Kappa. Yeah, that's something like that. I'm quite sure it's like that, but I have seen the Golden Kappa once. But yeah, you get the special skill, and then you can bind this skill to one of your... It's more like a proc. You bind this proc to one of your skills. So Tsunami has 100% chance to proc on a skill. So I bound it to my slam attack, which is basically my default attack with a 1.5 second recharge. And yeah, and then you get Tsunami skill, which does like an increased AoE every time you hit. So for example, if I hit right here, this big blue wave is a tsunami. And the devotion skills level up, just like Path of Exile, in the sense that as you get EXP, your skills get EXP as well. And yeah, so it's kind of a mix of Path of Exile and Diablo, I would say. And I think respeccing in Grimdawn isn't as punishing as it is in Path of Exile, where you have to spend a crap load of regret orbs, typically, in order to respec. I think you still have to spend money to respec in Grimdawn, but it's not as expensive. It's a nice change, it's a nice break from Path of Exile, but... I mean, once Atlas of Worlds, once the expansion comes out, I'm definitely going back. I would say that Grimdawn doesn't have as big of a competitive scene, or it definitely doesn't, and it more promotes sort of single player playthroughs, similar to Torchlight, and it encourages modding as well, I think. So you can add mods to your game. So if you play multiplayer, a lot of the times, I suspect a lot of the items are, you know, modded items, and that's how they have such good gear. But obviously, it's not always the case.
I can't do that.
Oh my god! Wait. Ah, lol, that is you, right, Alex? Or am I just talking to a random viewer?
That skill's not ready.
Magic metal. Okay. Okay, good. Well, this is a pretty good glove. Poison resistance, health, armor, pierce resistance. Okay, let's put it here. I may consider equipping that. Oh, these boots are pretty good too. Hmm. It lowers my poison resistance. I mean, at this point I have quite a bit of poison resistance. And a lot of fire lightning too. That's surprising. I have very shitty bleed resist. How's my pierce resist? So I have terrible resistances down here. Basically the dots. That's weird. So if I got... How's that? Not much difference, but I get more HP, right? I'll get more HP once I equip the bristly furs. Okay. I'm okay with that. So Alex, are you going to be attending our Pandemic Legacy play session? Next weekend, I believe. Alright, I think I explored everything I can explore. Obviously, there's still the Warden's Cellars. And I should check it out again. Because I didn't fully explore it last time around. How do I get onto the main road? Okay, like this. And then we go around. I will be in the video Pandemic Legacy. I can't wait. I was suggesting that, well, for those of you who don't know, there's a board game called Pandemic Legacy, and our fourth player bailed on us. So we are planning to play with our buddy, Alex, who is not in our city, and we're trying to do it over Skype. I suggested that we try to put in, like, VR cameras and shit. I don't know how well that would work, though. A lot of logistics to figure out. I mean, that'd be so cool. Warden Creek's Journal. I've already seen that, right? But yeah, that'd be so cool. Playing on VR. Okay, let's go into the cellar. I mean, I really wish that they would release, like, a... Someone would release a YouTube series. Like, Tabletop. The next step for Tabletop. Hosted by Will Wheaton would be like tabletop in VR, and you just put a VR camera in there. I mean, all the editing would be a nightmare, but it would be just so amazing to watch. I would totally watch it. Board gaming in virtual reality. Alright. I mean, it definitely feels stronger compared to... Ooh, epic hand gloves. Compared to when I first came into the Warden Cellar, like, these monsters are pretty tough, so... Physical damage, cunning. 15% chance when hit by melee attacks. ...360 video gaming section. Yeah. I lose resistances, but epic gloves. Epic! How can you say no? Let's do it. Although defense is still our biggest problem right now. I definitely wouldn't mind farming the warden a couple times, just for levels and items. I don't think I had like a decent weapon or like a item upgrade for quite a few levels already. Oh man, it still hurts so much. Oh, Rifui. Welcome to the stream. Hello. Glad you could come and watch us play some Grim Dawn, some newbie Grim Dawn. Right now we're just kind of farming the warden cellar. We have killed the warden before, but I mean, this is a pretty decent area to level up, I think. And there's a lot of areas I haven't fully explored yet, so I want to do that as well. Hopefully we find some secret areas, find some shrines, get some devotion points. I would like that. Playing some newbie Grim Dawn years myself. This is a good game. I'm enjoying it so far. I hope you are enjoying it as well. I believe there was a Grim Dawn sale, so there have been a lot more players getting into it recently. This is sort of the Path of Exile off-season. So I figured it was a good time to, you know, get into Grim Dawn, try it out, see what all the hype is about. And honestly, the hype is well-deserved. It's a good game. Oh, crumbling wall. Baby. Give me something good. Hidden spoils. Yo, dog, no wonder it's hidden spoils. This is all trash. Keep hiding it. No one wants it. Ooh, another strong box. Nope. You know what? We can try to sell this stuff. Considering that the game is only made by 8 people, yep, I very much agree. It has definitely blown my expectations. To be fair though, these guys do have some ARPG experience, right? They are the ones that made Titan Quest. Okay, I want to keep that so I can take the component out. Resistant ribbon. 19 fire. That's like 39 combined resistances. Can't get rid of that. Or no, the other one. The other one is 15 plus 12, 27. But health and damage. Yeah, I got rid of this. I really do need a new belt, though. It's okay, I guess. Okay, let me take out some of these components. I don't need them anymore. Keep add-on. Keep add-on. And then let's put this in the gloves. And the helmet? Alright. The soundtrack is really good for Grim Dawn as well. It really gets you into the zombie slaying mood. All right. So where do I go exactly? Okay, let's keep exploring this way. Oh man, Tsunami is such an awesome skill. Just loving it so much, man. Yeah, it's good I'm leveling here. Like, to be fair, I'm still technically under-leveled, right? Because the monsters are monster level 25 over here, and I'm only 24. I mean, I'm not under-leveled by much, but I bet I'm still getting really good EXP over here. And clear speed is pretty decent too, so this is a good farm. The zone scale with level, that is. It does? I was not aware of that. So, does that mean there's no point in leveling? And that I should just progress? But then eventually you start hitting walls. What are you supposed to do then? That's my problem right now. Not all zones, but most. Huh. Well, I mean, that's good to know. I'm still gonna continue to explore here since I've never been. But if I'm done the exploration, I guess I move on. Ow. You know what? That's good information. You have 4 acts to complete. With level 45 to 50 to aim for at the end of normal veteran mode. Yeah, but I'm starting to hit a wall, you know? Where it's like, they do so much damage to me, I have to kite around all day. I had assumed that, you know, my levels would carry me, or my items. But maybe having a proper skill build might actually be, you know, important. Difference between normal and veteran is the amount of special mobs you find. Okay. That does make sense. I think when I used to play non-veteran mode, it was just a lot of normal mobs. Well, the moment I went to veteran mode, I started seeing a lot of, like, those hero mobs. Okay, let's try going this way. Unless hero mobs don't count. I'm assuming when you say special mobs, it's hero mobs. Ow, so much damage. Or it could be these magic mobs? Well, these are the yellow ones. Maybe you find more of them in veteran mode? It's possible. Hero and yellow mobs. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Because I find I fight a lot of yellow mobs. It's kind of weird getting used to it because I'm primarily a Path of Exile player. And when I see yellow mobs, I just assume rare mobs. But in Grimdawn, that means there are magic mobs, so like, you know, tier 2 mobs or whatever. Kinda weird. So hard to get used to. Like in Grimdawn, you got the white mobs, the yellow mobs, and then I guess the hero mobs. But in Path of Exile, you got white mobs, blue mobs, and yellow mobs. It's like the complete opposite. And here, I think it's white, yellow, green? No. White, yellow, orange? Blue? Something like that? Either way, it's a little different. Hard to get used to. The heck is that? Excuse me, I'd like to get my item. Let me pick it up, please. Okay. This is it? Alright. The areas are mostly explored now. Alright, there's a hero mob. Oh, he's so fast! Oh, everything hurts. Send help. Living life on the edge! Alright, we good. We good. Ah, another tainted brain matter, that's good. Soul shard. Okay. Alright, don't think I want to be here. Oh, it hurts. It hurts, Daddy!
That skill's not ready.
Why is my defense so shit? I guess today I'm just gonna redo the warden. Get some farm out of it. Some items. I just need more skill points. I need more levels. A lot of stuff, man. I wonder what my defensive options are, though. Because right now I need to really think about it. I guess I need better defensive skills. I wish I could freeze them more easily. That would help. Or like Life Leech maybe? Something. I need survivability. Alright. Let's get down into further down into the warden's, was it the laboratory or something? Underground transit.